Howdy, everybody. Here we are, all ready to take you down to Pine Ridge for another visit with Lum and Abner. Brought to you by the makers of Horlicks, the original malted milk. How many of you radio listeners have trouble getting to sleep some nights, lie tossing around waiting for sleep that seems never to come? Quite a few of you, probably. All of you I know at some time or another. And here's a suggestion that's proved helpful to many in this predicament. One that I think might prove helpful to you. Before going to bed, drink a glass full of Horlicks malted milk. Hot. You'll notice a difference at once. It soothes and relaxes you. Helps you to fall asleep easily and naturally. And that's not all. Horlicks helps you to sleep soundly. You know, scientists have shown us that broken sleep isn't restful sleep. To be really beneficial, it must be deep and continuous, they say. And that's a good point to remember. We all need plenty of good, continuous sleep, both young and old. It builds up resistance to illnesses, too. Why not try Horlicks tonight? You'll be surprised how much fresher you'll feel in the morning. Remember, a glass full of Horlicks malted milk, hot, just before going to bed. And now, let's see what's happening down in Pine Ridge. Well, yesterday was the last day of the contest in which the public was asked to select the president for Lum and Abner's new store. Squire Skimp, Abner's campaign manager, and who is particularly interested in the outcome of the election, has demanded an official count of the votes sent in. And so as we look in on Pine Ridge today, we find Lum and Abner waiting in the front part of the store while Dick Huddleston, Grandpappy Spears, and Squire Skimp are back in the feed room making a final count of the votes. Listen.
Well, I wish they'd hurry up in there. I'm getting tired of waiting.
Yeah. I could have had them votes counted 2 hours ago. All we needed to do was just count the votes that come in today and add them to what we already had counted.
Yeah, but Squire's going back over all the votes, though. Counting the whole business over again.
Yeah, he's bound and determined that you're going to get elected. He's wanting that 10% you agreed to pay him if you get elected.
Yeah, sure. That's what's worrying him all right.
It's a good thing we got Grandpappy and Dick back there watching him. He'd claim he's elected regardless of how many votes you got.
Well, I tried to withdraw from a race, and Squire claimed that on account of signing that contract that I had to stay in there.
Well, I think I'll win it all right, so I wouldn't worry none about it if I was you.
Well, it's your trouble, Lum. I'm going to be disappointed either way it goes.
Disappointed?
Yeah, if I win, I'm going to hate to pay Squire 10% of everything I make for the rest of my life. If you win, why, I'm going to be disappointed because I never got to be president of the store.
Well, now, you oughtn't to feel that way about it, Abner. We left it up to the folks out on the party line to elect whichever one they wanted. And when it gets beat, or to take it in the right spirit. Don't want to have no hard feelings over one another.
Oh, no, I ain't sure. I ain't going to get mad at nobody over it.
Well,
no.
That's fine. If there's anything I hate, is a poor loser. Well, there they come. Well, who in the office, Dick?
Well, we're not through yet, Lum. I just come out to get a drink of water. You got any drinking water around here?
Yeah, there's a bucket right there on the end of the counter, Dick. Cedric just brought it and brung it in a while ago.
How long will it be before you're through, Dick?
Yeah, we're getting sort of curious out here.
Well, it oughtn't to be long, just a few minutes, I reckon. We've got all the votes counted now, and we got to total them up.
Well, how's it looking? Can you tell anything about it yet?
Well, yeah, I believe Abner's a little ahead, the best I can tell, Lum.
Abner is?
Well, good. No. Dad, blame it, I wish I could make up my mind whether I want to get elected or not.
I thought you'd want me to get the offer so you wouldn't have to pay Squire nothing.
Well, I don't know which I want.
Take that bucket on in there with you, Dick, if you mind to. Give him other fellas a drink.
Oh, we'll be through in there directly, Lum, and we'll let you know it as soon as we can.
All right, Dick.
I don't get. I can't wait to tell Elizabeth. And she's going to be awful proud of me being president of the store.
Yeah, but wait till she finds out you're paying Squire 10% of everything you make just for managing a campaign for you. She won't be so proud of you.
Dad, blame him. Dad, blame him. Swan, too goodness, he gets me so aggravated every time I think of him, I could run butt my head against something. Swan, too goodness.
I tried to tell you, and you wouldn't listen to me. The only way to get along with Squire Skimp's just to stay away from him.
Wish I knowed some way of getting even with him. That's what I wish.
Yeah. We'll find a change. According to that contract, you have to pay him 10% of what you make on your farm, and 10% of everything you make here in the store, and 10% of your constable fees, and 10% of everything, I reckon.
Yeah, I know it. Yeah, according to that, I pay him 10% of everything I make from here out.
Well, we just bide our time. We'll find a change. He's imposed on us for years around here, and I'm getting just about enough of it. The only way to get even with a feller like that is just to give him a dose of his own medicine.
Huh? Give him what?
I say we'll give him a dose of his own medicine.
Is he sick?
No. He will be again we get done with him about you.
Oh, give him something that'll make him sick, huh?
Yeah, we'll make him wish he'd never tried out any of them crooked schemes on us.
Yeah, that'll fix him, yes, sir. That's the worst tasting stuff I ever put in my mouth.
What's the worst tasting stuff?
Why, that medicine here that we're going to give him a dose of.
What medicine are you talking about?
Why, that and that he's got the agency for us. I bought a bottle of it off of him the other day. We can just give him that. I just taken one dose out of it.
Well, I ain't talking about that kind of medicine, no, Abner.
It'll sure make him sick. I can guarantee you that. It's awful.
Well, I know the kind of medicine I'm talking about, though, will be a heap worse than anything he ever had.
Yeah. I tell you what we can do, Lum. Just take all the worst-tasting medicine we can think of and mix them up together. Acetophilites and castor oil and quinine and sulfur and apple bitter.
Well, wait a minute, Abner. You still don't know what I'm talking about.
Well, now, if you can think up a worse mixture than that, I'd like to hear it.
You ought to know we couldn't get Squire to take no such conglomeration as that.
Well, no, of course, it's going to be hard. I know that. I expect we're just going to have to make him take it, just force him down.
You still don't know what I mean. When I said we'd give him a dose of his own medicine, I didn't mean we'd sure enough give him no medicine.
Oh, just make him think it is, huh?
No.
Well, now, we could do that all right, Lum. We could mix up anything we wanted to, you know, and put it in that bottle that his medicine come in, fool him that way.
Oh, for
sure. He wouldn't know the difference till he got it in his
Abner,
mouth.
Abner, will you shut up about giving him a dose of medicine?
Well, you were the one that brung it up. I never even thought about it till you started.
I said we'd get even with him, give him a dose of it. No, just forget about the medicine.
Forget about it?
Yeah.
Not going to use it, huh?
No, never aim to start with. I just said
it. Oh, you just saying that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What I mean, we'll study up something to pull on him that's just as bad as some of the stunts he's pulled on us.
Yeah, well, Lum, my opinion now, that medicine will come just as nigh done as anything I know of, if we can figure out some way to get him to take it.
Abner, if you say medicine one more time, I'm going to whop you on. I'm trying to help you study up something that'll beat him at his own game, and all you want to do is talk about medicine.
Yeah, well, let's see. Now, that brings up something else. Now, what kind of a game could we study up where we could get the best of him, Lum?
Game?
Yeah, I know we can beat him at checkers, but, Lord me, I don't see how that's going to get even with him. No, I still think the medicine's the best idea.
Not one, Abner. You're the hardest feller to explain anything to I ever seen. You get something on your mind, it'd take a stick of dynamite to jar it out. I said a while ago that we'd get even with Squire by giving him a dose of his own medicine, and you thought it.
Yeah,
was...
but don't you know now, Lum, you've changed your mind about that now. You want to beat him at his own game, you say.
Well, that's the same thing, Abner. Same thing exactly. That's what I'm trying to tell you.
Oh. You mean that giving somebody a dose of medicine is some kind of a game?
No, Abner. Wait a minute. Here they come.
Huh?
Here they come. I reckon they've got the votes counted.
Well, fellas, the election is all over.
Well, who was elected?
Well, Grandpap's got the figures there. Go ahead and read them, Grandpap.
Well, now, according to our count, fellas, Lum, you was elected by 17 votes majority.
Lum was elected.
Well, fine.
Yes, sir.
I know it all the time.
The votes that come in today was mighty nigh every one for Lum. If you'd have stayed with me, Abner, instead of getting out here working for Lum these last few days, well, I'd have got you elected by a big majority.
Did working for me?
Why, yes, that's just what he done, Lum. That announcement that he made on the party line the other day, asking all his friends to vote for him, is just what beat him.
Abner, did you ask the folks out on the party line to vote for me?
Yeah, I figured that was a... best way out of it, Lum. I know that if you got elected, that contract that I had with Squire wouldn't be no count then.
You mean that you done that for me, Abner, and knowing how bad you wanted the office and all?
Well, I just figured that was about the only thing left for me to do. I couldn't make up my mind whether I wanted it or wanted you to get it, and so I just decided to ask the folks to vote for you, and then if they done it, why, I wouldn't have to pay Squire the 10% no more.
One, two, goodness. And by the way, Squire, I reckon you're satisfied now that I was elected.
Oh, sure, there's no doubt about that, Lum. We went back and counted every vote to come in.
Well, Squire, that contract that you got Abner to sign won't do you no good now, then.
No, I reckon not, Lum.
Well, if you don't mind, just hand that back to Abner, then, so he can tear it up.
Oh, yeah, sure. No, I ain't got no use for it no more. Here, Abner.
Yeah, much obliged.
All right. That gets that contract out of the way, then. According to the vote, I'm elected president of the Jot 'em Down store. But I've got sense enough to know that I wouldn't have been elected if Abner hadn't got out here and asked his friends to vote for me.
No, I don't believe you would either, Lum.
Now, I've always been president of the store here ever since we started, and I hate to give up the office. But I know Abner's always wanted to hold the office.
Well, yes, did want to be president mighty bad, Lum. I had some new ideas that I want to try out in the store business, but you was elected, so I reckon just forget about it.
Now, what I started to say, Abner would have had to pay Squire 10% of everything he made if he'd been elected. But he can't collect nothing off of him if I just give the office to Abner. From now on, Abner's going to be president of the Jot 'em Down store. I'm turning the office over to you, Abner. Let's see what you can do with it.
And one of Abner's lifelong ambitions has now been realized. President Abner Peabody. And now, we are told that Mr. and Mrs. Temple have just finished dinner. Let's see what they're talking about.
Jim, I've been thinking.
Hmm?
Thinking about Tommy. You know, he's not well.
Oh,
Jim, will you listen to me? Put down that paper just for a minute.
Oh, sure. What's the matter, dear?
Well, it's Tommy. He says he won't go to that party tomorrow.
Oh, what party?
The Barclays party. All the neighborhood children are going.
Oh, well, why won't he go?
Says he'd rather stay home.
What? Stay home? At his age? Say, why, when I was a boy... Say, that reminds me of something that Dick Chesterton told me. Said his boy used to be that way, too. Stayed indoors all the time. Never played much with the bunch.
Why, but Dick's boy is as lively as he can be these days. Why, I notice him every morning. Well, what did Dick do?
Just let the youngster drink plenty of Horlicks malted milk. Said it worked wonders for the boy. You know, Horlicks is a fine source of nourishment. Contains vitamins and energy elements that build strength and resistance. Let's get some Horlicks for Tommy, dear. Dick says that all kids love to drink it. It's so delicious.
You bet all youngsters love to drink Horlicks. And this fine food drink, made from only rich, full cream milk, and the best of wheat and malted barley, helps the youngsters to develop sound, muscular bodies, and strong bones and teeth. You can get Horlicks, you know, either natural or chocolate flavor, at your druggist's. This is Carlton Bricker, speaking for Lum and Abner and Horlicks, who now bid you all good night and good health.